birthday long weekend is coming up in most parts of Australia, so what better way to get into the spirit than to serve up an English classic? We are joined by one of our favourite chefs, Jason Roberts. Welcome to the show.
I love being your favourite chef.
Birthday to the Queen.
Yeah, it's Queenie's birthday, and what better way to celebrate than bangers and mash?
I couldn't agree more. We've made a little bit of a twist. I've got a couple of ideas. I know this is a bit of a competition. I'm not very competitive, but maybe a little bit.
Listen, you're opening a restaurant in at 12 o'clock.
Oh, my God.
You're
I'm opening a restaurant at 12 o'clock today. Mandy Pavilion, I hope to see you guys down there.
Now, fantastic. So Jason and Denise, you're going head-to-head in the bangers bake-off. And you've each got a secret ingredient to make your bangers and mash a little bit special.
Yeah, it's heat right now.
which is honestly really helps if you're cooking.
Yeah.
Is that as high as it goes?
All right. How many chefs that take the turn on an oven?
Mm.
So this is an induction range here, Denise.
I know that.
All right.
Don't try and tell me something I don't know.
Oh, God, you're one of them.
All right.
So we've got some sausages.
No, just your opinion.
Okay.
Are these good to use at home?
There is actually a safety feature. Hold on. I'm totally up for this, by the way. So there's a great safety feature here. If the pan's not on, it's not going to get hot. So if you've got young children, unless there's something hot, they can't pull it down. In fact, there was someone in me. That's why we do it with Denise. Okay, darling. Upstairs.
I'm used to it.
To you.
I've got broad shoulders.
So I think it's a great... So you have ceramic, you have induction, you have gas. So there's no naked flame, which I think is really cool.
All right, well, let's get cooking.
All right, cooking.
So you're doing your...
I'm doing...
Can I... Why are the sausages like that?
Because I can fit more in a bag. Actually, these are sausages...
In a bag?
I make these sausages at the restaurant, okay?
Oh, okay,
So these are real pig's intestines. These are got pork in them, fennel, garlic, chilli.
Yummy.
So I'm giving you a hand up already here. These aren't store-bought, chemical-free, gluten-free, super delicious.
They're real sausages.
Real sausages.
Okay.
Oh, and that's my hat.
Now, listen.
And not a real hat.
Now, what are you doing with this mash? You've put collie in the mash.
Okay, so this is actually cooked. Let me help you out with that. Now, you have a secret ingredient. I have a secret ingredient. I think the trick here is actually just to mash everything up nice, a little bit of...
But you've got collie with potatoes.
Yes.
Okay, you're allowed.
Okay, the reason being is because I have kids, and I think there's this whole importance of giving them a wide variety of fruits and vegetables. Okay, cauliflower being white. But if you think you can mash that for us, Denise, do you want to check on a little bit of butter?
So will they taste that, or are you secretly putting the cauliflower in to hide it?
No, they will taste it,
but it'll lower the amount of starch content. I'm a big believer in eating a wide variety of fruits and vegetables, okay?
How much butter are we...
I'm not going to look, Denise.
Don't look.
Do what you like, love.
If you're going to eat,
this is English.
Eat
this is for the Queen. It's once a year, right? And there's a little bit of double cream.
Beautiful. Throw that in.
All right.
Oh, my God. Cream and butter.
Yes.
How do you think the Queen's taste so beautiful and her skin so supple and moist?
Would you live to...
You're talking about 90?
Yeah, and the Queen. Well, you know, I think it's about nourishing your body. Food's made from food. I actually really agree with it.
Can I ask something? Back to the sausages.
Yes.
When you buy them from the store, what are you getting? It's best not to think about that.
I actually used to think it was bums and noses. But
bums
in fact,
and
but not this day and age. People are really artisanal. If you go to a good butcher, they're artisanal. Right. And they'll use good cuts of meat. They know where their meat comes from, how it's sourced, making sure that it's antibiotic free and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. So this is what we're at about. This is actually pork shoulder and pork cheek.
I'll do it this way.
Oh, I like it.
Because you get exercise like that.
And a little bit. You like pepper?
Oh, I've done that.
Oh, okay, you've done that. Pepper and that.
So are you guys doing your own separate recipes?
I just think we love working together.
All right, okay.
I actually need a few more chefs in my restaurant. And this was a bit of a trial, Denise.
I'm actually doing pineapple sausage surprise.
You know what?
What's the surprise?
Yeah, what's the surprise?
I'm not telling you.
Okay.
Would it be a surprise if I said?
Okay, can I tell you what my surprise is? I'm actually going to tell you about this. This goes back to the cauliflower. I'm actually using sauerkraut, and sauerkraut that I've made myself and fermented.
I have to taste that.
Okay, do you know why they're...
No.
Okay, you can't taste it because the guy upstairs said you can't.
That gets really hard on the ear.
Yeah, I know.
What's his name?
Rob. Tried that's 2.5 hours.
What's his name?
Rob, he's the boss.
Rob, why don't you come down here and taste this, mate?
Now, the sauerkraut...
I will say.
Can I just say one thing?
Yes.
They're going to end up with pink tummies.
What do you mean, pink tummies?
You know, when you open them and they've got pink tummies. I like to slice mine and cut them in half and
turn
them
up. Slice it.
Do the old stab, you know, when you've got to let air out.
So you undo the...
Okay. I'm hurrying.
Okay, slice it, love.
Don't slice.
Slice it. I thought the pineapple would have fit perfectly on top.
No, 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 you don't do it like that.
I'm going to take one for me then, so you don't, like, because I like the round thing.
Well, I'm going to keep mashing because it looks
you
lumpy.
Keep mashing.
All right,
that's
you do
the
that.
Collie in it.
Right.
That's not my fault, it's his.
Oh, but it's textural. Denise, it's textural.
That's going to happen.
This is a wide variety of fruits and vegetables, making sure you get the phytonutrients and phytochemicals and stuff like that. And the reason for doing sauerkraut, look, you're building
good
muscles
exercise.
There,
Joe. It actually is good
muscles.
Exercise.
Right. Will
this
we play
good
that?
For the microbiome. Good for the microbiome, guys. Get into some sauerkraut. It's good for the microbiome.
So let's play it up, guys, because we are running out of time. We are going to taste test this after a... After seeing Craig Bennett. What I love about the Brits is that your national dish really is just sausages and mashed potato.
It's so unreal. Easy. I love it.
And it's just so edible when you're over there. It's cold. It's nice,
beans.
Cozy.
I think we do better sausages here in Australia.
Really?
Just saying.
Why?
Yeah, because
bigger
I don't
ones?
Think... Yeah, no, but I think because we do a hard wrap read on. What was that? Sorry.
You're talking to me. You're talking
no,
to me.
No, sorry. Because we use real good ingredients. We're super conscious of it. And we try not to use fillers where possible.
Well, we're going to get the whole panel to taste test. Oh, my gosh. These delicious meals and declare a winner in just a moment. And if you are in the mood for a laugh, stay right where you are. Joe's What in the Weird is coming up. Can we get a quick shot of this very quickly? Let's have a look what everyone's
okay.
laughing at. Chef Jason Roberts and Denise have been busy cooking the British classic bangers and mash to celebrate the Queen's birthday long weekend. They've each gone with their own special recipe, their own special take on the classic. This is Jason's.
Actually, mine's more German, sauerkraut. I don't know what I was thinking, Denise.
And Denise, you've added a bit of an Aussie flair.
Pineapple sausage surprise.
Oh, that's certainly Christmas. A surprise.
That's more like a red belly button.
That would be a winner on a kid's plate.
Let's taste it.
I think I'm going to put it on the menu today at the Manly Pavilion and we'll call
for
it
the kids.
The Denise.
The Denise, the Donna.
Thanks for celebrating my birthday with me.
The ding dong, the ding dong.
Are you going to feed me fire?
Oh, do you want some?
Yeah. Get in.
You can call it the donger.
Give me some of your donger.
Mm.
Do you want sauce on it?
Yes, please.
Do you approve sauce on sausages?
Where's my sauce?
Yeah, no,
okay.
Oh, actually, I don't mind. If you like sauce, you know what? Tomato's a good sauce. I like a pink. It's good for the heart. Go for gold.
Okay.
Oh, sauce.
Denise, that is delicious.
Is it?
From a fellow queen on Queen's birthday weekend. That is right.
Get in there.
It's creepy.
Are they any good?
Beautiful.
Got to say, the potato's a bit lumpy, Jason, but that might be the cauliflower.
I think it's a collie.
Mmm.
Wally.
Mm. Oh, I like the cauliflower.
Your sausages are beautiful.
Thank you, Denise. Thank you.
Yummy. Oh, I've got to say.
Sorry, Jason.
I'm going to vote for Jason.
All right.
That's all right. I don't care.
I'm going to give it to Denise because I have to work with
her. I'm voting for Denise.
Oh, look, it's all...
Everyone.
Yay!
I just like I like the snake eyes. That's sort of a bit cool.
A right. Big thank you to Jason Roberts, everyone. You've been amazing.